Greetings. Welcome to a new episode of None of My Business. And with me is Pia Bawani, a very famous model in Oman. If you're born in Jamaica, what would you be doing?
I would be dancing on the streets, trying all the street food and enjoying street music.
Who said hasta la vista?
You, right now. Yes, it is you.
Someone important.
The first thought that came to my mind was Spielberg, but I'm sure that's wrong. So let's go with Mr. Arnold.
Hey.
Which food can tackle an angry spouse?
Angry spouse? I think home food. There's nothing more warm than home food.
Yeah, what kind fresh. Of food?
Well, I'm an Indian, so I would say something more like, you know, a khichdi or an idli or a dosa.
Okay. So. Sing two lines from a song of love.
On love?
Yeah.
Oh my God, my singing is really bad.
Only two lines. Please.
On love, ae dil hai mushkil. That's all I know. Or, I don't know. Love is beautiful. I'm sure there are many songs like that.
Does a man look cool with beard?
Definitely.
Why do you?
It's very manly, it's very macho, and it defines a character, I think. You know, he has his own personality, you know, he has his own identity. So I think, yeah, man with beard.
Okay. A day without smartphone or a night without sleep?
Of course, a day without smartphone. Any day.
Why?
Because I want my beauty sleep. I have to look nice for next day projects. So I can stay without my phone, but not my sleep.
Did you ever steal anything from your parents or your grandparents?
Yes, my dad's pen. My dad had this huge thing for pens, and every time, and at that point, even cross pens are like very, very expensive. So I remember he used to buy a lot of fancy pens, and I was very curious to see, you know, how is a pen literally made? Like what goes inside and how is the spring? So I would always steal all his pens and go to the bathroom. Remove one by one and see what sort of refills go in there, what sort of spring is inside, and then once I have literally ruined it, I don't know how to fix it back. So I would always keep all the pens underneath the bed. Okay. So I think, yeah, most of his pens I stole.
In the next 30 years, what will people be nostalgic about?
I'm not sure what people will be nostalgic as such, but people will definitely remember 2020 and how lockdown was, and how spending time with family was at that point, with all the night curfews, and you know, and there was, in spite of all this uncertainty and the fear and insecurity, there was always this interesting, you know, thought as to what's going to be out in the news tomorrow. Are they going to remove the lockdown? Are they going to open the doors? You know, there was always some sort of, you know, interesting expectation about future, about the next day. So I think that would be something interesting for people to remember.
Yes, Pia, you got it right, because COVID has been very painful for us, for everyone. Nobody will ever forget about it. However, let's be hopeful. Things will get better very soon. My next question is, how do you react when someone honks behind you or beside you while on the road?
If someone's honking behind me, I'd be like, what, you know, like, wait, you know, or be like, oh, stop, you know, like, I would. But my first reaction would be a smile on my face, because I would wonder, like, what is wrong with this man, you know, like, why is he crazy?
Which Disney character suits you better?
I think mermaid. I'm more of, I'm a beach bunny. I love anything to do with sea, and that's probably why I love Oman as well. You throw me in the sea, you throw me anywhere closer to sea, I can live there all alone without anything next to me or anyone around me. So I think I would probably be a mermaid.
What's more important, innocence or experience?
I think experience. I really believe in experience, because experience can sort of teach you when you want to be ignorant, when you want to be calm, when you want to be, when you want to throw the right attitude at the right place or carry yourself, and how to react to situation. And I think most of us at this point need to learn how to deal with situations rather than, you know, innocently waiting for some miracle and magic to happen and the world's going to be a beautiful place. No, not at all. So I believe it's more of experience.
Pia Bawani, thank you very much.